The node voltage method is a systematic approach to solving for voltages and currents in circuits in which we identify the voltages on the nodes and then apply KCL at each node.
A node is a collection of wires that all has the same voltage. Okay, so this particular circuit has three nodes. One, two, three. The first step in the node voltage method is to pick one of the nodes as our reference node. And then every voltage will be defined with respect to that node. So in this particular case, we could identify this node as our reference. Then that voltage will be called V1. And that voltage would be called V2. Here's our alternative. We could label this node as our reference, and then we would identify that voltage as V3 and that voltage as V2. We're going to pick this bottom node. The reason is that this allows us to identify that this node voltage is already defined. It's clearly 10 volts due to the voltage source. Okay, so we have 10 volts. This voltage is our only unknown voltage. We'll call that voltage Vx. Now, voltage Vx, we're going to solve for this voltage by considering current flowing out of node X. We'll call that current I1, this next current I2, and this current we'll label as I3. So the current law says that the sum of the currents flowing out of node X has to be summed up to zero. What we're going to do is solve for each of those currents by considering Ohm's law or other considerations for each device as to how to understand what the current is. So let's break this down over here. Let's start with current through this device, which we have labeled I1. For a resistor, if that voltage across the device was V, Ohm's law would say that V is equal to I1 times R. For this device, the resistance is 6,000. So how do we solve for V? Well, we can calculate V by considering KVL around the following loop. This voltage, we already know, is 10. And that voltage, we don't know the value of that, but we have defined it as Vx. So the KVL law for that loop says that 10 plus V equals Vx. That means that V is Vx minus 10. And so finally, we can solve for I1 is V over R, which is Vx minus 10 over 6,000. Okay, so coming back to our original equation, we can write now, we've solved for I1. I1 is simply Vx minus 10 over 6,000. And we can do a similar process for I2 and I3. So I2 is, again, Vx minus the destination voltage is 0. The resistance is 8,000. And I3, we can see from the current source, is actually minus 3 milliamps. That sums up to 0. All right, doing this calculation by hand, I'm going to multiply by 24,000. This gives me 4 Vx minus 40. Plus 3 Vx minus 24 times 3 is 72. Notice that the milliamps multiplied by 24,000 ohms converts to a voltage. So we're left with 7Vx is equal to 112. And doing a quick calculation, that leads to Vx is 16 volts. Going back to the original circuit, you can see that I1 Vx minus 10 is 6 volts over 6 kiloohms, which gives us 1 milliamp. And I2 is 16 volts over 8 kiloohms, giving us 2 milliamps. And you can see that KCL at node X is okay. Every other circuit variable we can now read off. That is, the current through the 10 volt source is the same as I1. The voltage across the current source is the same as Vx. It is 16 volts.